Do you feel nervous when you have to give a big presentation or stressed out before an exam? Do you worry when you make important decisions? We all feel anxious now and then. Occasional anxiety is a normal emotion. It's our brain's survival mechanism that signals our body to react to danger with a fight or flight response. But anxiety disorders are different from this temporary worry or fear. For those of us who develop an anxiety disorder, the feelings of fear and worry are constant and overwhelming, and they often tend to get worse over time. There are several types of anxiety disorders with their own symptoms and treatments. So without further ado, here are five major anxiety disorders. Number 1. Generalized anxiety disorder. This consists of persistent, vague, and excessive worry with little or no reason. The person is often aware that there is no reason for them to worry. The worries usually focus on everyday things such as financial responsibilities, family health, or minor matters such as daily chores, car repairs, or appointments. This ongoing worry and tension interferes with daily activities and may be accompanied by physical symptoms like restlessness, feeling on edge, fatigue, difficulty in concentrating, muscle tension, and even problems sleeping. Number 2. Panic disorder. The core symptom of panic disorder is recurrent panic attack, in which the person experiences overwhelming terror when there is no real danger. Panic attacks are sudden periods of intense fear that come on quickly and reach their peak within minutes. They may be expected, such as a response to a feared object, or unexpected, occurring for no apparent reason. During an attack, several of the following symptoms occur in combination: palpitations, pounding heart or rapid heart rate, sweating, trembling and shaking, feeling of shortness of breath, chest pain, feeling dizzy, lightheaded or faint, feeling of choking, numbness or tingling, chills or hot flashes, nausea, feeling detached, fear of losing control, and fear of dying. Many people who experience a panic attack may believe they are having a heart attack or other life-threatening illness because of the severity of symptoms. They may go to a hospital emergency room. Panic attacks may co-occur with other mental disorders such as depression or PTSD. A phobia is an overwhelming fear, usually of something that poses no real danger at all. Let's look at two different types of phobias: specific phobias and agoraphobia. A specific phobia is excessive and persistent fear of a specific object, situation, or activity that is generally not harmful. A person suffering from a specific phobia knows that the fear is excessive but can't overcome it and will go to great lengths to avoid what they fear because of the degree of distress that it causes. Examples of specific phobias are fear of public speaking, fear of flying, or fear of spiders. Agoraphobia is an intense fear of being in a place where it seems hard to escape or get help if an emergency occurs. The fear is out of proportion to the actual situation and generally lasts for 6 months or more and causes problems in functioning. A person with agoraphobia experiences this fear in two or more of the following situations: using public transportation, being in open places, being in enclosed places, standing in line or being in a crowd, and being outside of the home alone. Untreated agoraphobia can be so serious that a person is unable to leave the house. Agoraphobia is only diagnosed if the fear is intensely upsetting or if it significantly interferes with normal daily activities. Number 4. Social anxiety disorder. This was previously known as social phobia. Social anxiety disorder consists of extreme fear in social settings. It causes significant anxiety and discomfort about being embarrassed, rejected, humiliated, or looked down upon in social interactions. The anxiety gets in the way of daily activities and lasts for at least 6 months. A person suffering from social anxiety will either try to avoid the situation or endure it with great anxiety. Common examples are extreme fear of public speaking, meeting new people, or eating and drinking in public. Number 5. Separation anxiety disorder. Separation anxiety is a normal part of childhood development, but it usually disappears around age 2. However, some children have symptoms of separation anxiety during their teenage years and even into adulthood. A person with this disorder is excessively fearful or anxious about separation from parents or caregivers. The feeling is beyond what is appropriate for the person's age. It lasts for at least 4 weeks in children and 6 months in adults and causes problems problems functioning. A person with separation anxiety disorder feels very anxious or fearful when a person they're close with leaves their sight and may be constantly worried about losing the person closest to them. Patients may refuse to go out or sleep away from home or without the person that they are attached to and may experience nightmares about the separation. So these are the five major anxiety disorders. It can be challenging and frustrating to live with anxiety. If you've been diagnosed with an anxiety disorder, that's okay. Millions of people across the world suffer from anxiety disorders and know what it feels like. So you're not alone. All these types of anxiety disorders are treatable and manageable. If you know someone who suffers from anxiety disorders and may benefit from online counseling, make sure to check out the links we've shared in the description box below. If you found this video helpful, remember to share it with others who might benefit from it. And please subscribe to the channel. As always, thanks for watching.